أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Peace and blessings of Allah be upon all of you. Dear brothers and sisters, let's talk about the purpose of life. How do we start knowing the purpose of life? Let's start pondering upon the creation of this huge universe. Who has created this huge universe? In this large universe, who created this unique human being? Did these both just got created by itself? Is there any purpose for both of them? Human being born and then just dying? Is this the only fact? And then what happens after death? Have you pondered upon these type of questions? Let's just think. When we observe the universe, every element of this great universe seems to have been built with a purpose. Whether the trees or the rivers or the seas or the suns or the mountains, any natural thing or a man-made element, you would think has definitely got some purpose, right? So if everything should exist with some purpose, then would it not be that we also have a purpose? So for all of us and the universe around, if there is a purpose, then what is that purpose? And who would set that purpose? If a man-made machine or a car is shown the purpose by its own manufacturer, how to run it, how to maintain it, then similarly, the supreme being who has created this gigantic universe and the unique special creation human being should also be able to tell us the purpose of running our life, running our human body. Minds might throw up a doubt whether there exists a creator at all. Let's think about this. For anything to exist, there should be a cause and its effect. And more so, there should be a real cause for any effect to exist. For example, we observe that if a mosquito comes and sits on a teaching board on a wall hanging there, and we suddenly see it falling down, do we think really that the weight of the mosquito caused the board to fall on the ground? Hence, this doesn't seem to us that this is the right cause of the board falling down. That weight of the mosquito is just not that high that it causes the teaching board to fall down on earth. Can someone imagine a scenario where a strong wind comes, gathers some mud, makes measured bricks, arranges them properly, then builds a wall? Then some similar phantom processes causes the assembly of some windows and roofs, and it's painted, the gates are fixed, and a beautiful, gorgeous garden is made around it, and there's a neat parking lot comes out of it. Is the above making of an automatic building really a possibility? Similarly, even for this universe to come to existence, there cannot be a false process or a phantom cause. In fact, there should be a correct, perfect, and the most intelligent cause for this universe to exist in such a spectacularly perfect fashion. Let's take up three theories which human beings put out there. That this universe, it's been there, it doesn't have any end, just came by itself. The second one, it just got created by itself. And the third one, it just could be that a more correct, powerful, knowledgeable, accurate, supreme being might have designed and created the sun and the moon and the planets, which just do not collide each other, but run in a perfectly miraculous orbits. The distance between the orbits of planets perfected to millionth of a millimeter. If you look at the first theory, if we observe the universe, it is expanding each day. The matter is converting to energy, and the energy converting to matter. If we believe that this universe is by itself, then it should not decrease. according to the first law of thermodynamics, if matter converts into energy, there is a loss of some energy, and this process continues until there is nothing. This shows that universe was not existing by itself. It was in fact put into motion by someone. Did universe get created from nothing? Look, according to second law of thermodynamics, nothing cannot create something. As previously stated, it's just a wind gathering some mud, making some bricks. It just can't build a beautiful house by itself. Similarly, if we contemplate upon the creation of our body, who would be not starting to think that this most complex, seamless, integrated human being was in fact created by a supreme being with a purpose to perfection. This supreme being is in fact in the holy book Quran, explaining our creation thus. The creator says, "Verily, we have created the human from a quintessence of a clay. Then we placed him as a drop in a fixed resting place. We then made the drop into a clot and that into fetus. We then made bones and clothed the bones with the flesh. And from that brought forth another creation. Therefore, blessed is God, the very best of those who create." So let's discuss this journey of the human creation and its purpose of life in the next episode. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.